Are they still drunk? Are they hungover? Sophie and Daniel, definitely not sober.
You're listening to the Hangover You Don't Deserve podcast.
Hi guys, welcome to episode something of a Hangover You Don't Deserve podcast. What are we, episode 8 now?
Yeah, episode 8.
Yeah, welcome to episode 8.
Time flies when you're having fun.
That's one way of describing this terrible hangover. I'm Daniel. This is Sophie. Say hi, Sophie.
Hi.
Oh, it's like you have something wrong with you, honestly. I'm drinking a Bailey's iced coffee latte.
Oh, I didn't realise that was alcohol.
Yes, yeah.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, this was a bad one. I've got to be honest with you guys. This was a bad one.
We were already hungover when we started last night.
And it was a bad hangover too. I mean, like, I had about 2 hours from the point when I'd vomited from being so hungover to when we started drinking again for the podcast.
And I got up at like 4 p.m. after the night before. I met Daniel and Aisha 3 hours later.
And that was it. Let's begin drinking. So today has been a rough one. I mean, it's right now, it's 4:20 p.m. Blaze it, guys.
Yeah, nice. We usually...
It's 4:21, forget it. No, never mind.
We usually start recording, what, before noon?
10 a.m. we aim for, yeah.
Yeah. So it's slow starter.
And what we've done is walk around Liverpool trying to find a way to give ourselves a buzz enough to start this in a good mood. So as well as buying beer when we went to the shop, I also just bought some random cans and stuff that they had. They had these 3 for a 5 on, just all the weird ready mix drinks that they do. So
ready,
I just bought
drinks.
A load of...
So bad. In a can.
Yeah.
It's just the epitome of class, really.
Yeah, exactly. No, there's nothing classier than drinking a pink gin ready mix can. So, yeah, that's how today is going to be.
You sound really down.
Yeah, I feel it.
When we get... Don't worry, it'll get better.
Keep listening, guys. It's going to be okay. Fight through this with us. So, yeah, we were out in Liverpool last night. We've not been out in Liverpool for one of these for a while.
I'm glad we did that. I've been really excited.
Yeah. The first place we planned to go to was a place called Lane 7, which was... It's a bowling alley that also does alcohol. And then we got there. We were booked in for 7 p.m. and... We got there and they wouldn't let us in because Sophie didn't have ID and there's no children allowed on the premises after 7.
No children.
How old are you again, Sophie?
28.
Oh, yeah, that's right. 28 years old. You don't carry ID because 28-year-olds don't need to carry ID for anything because you're not going to the airport. So, what, you know?
And I don't drive, so I don't have a driver's license.
Yeah, just doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was that plan foiled. Fuck those guys.
But I'm kind of glad. Because we ended up in this new arcade bar.
Yeah.
Called, what, NQ64?
NQ64, which there's one in Manchester, in an area of Manchester called Northern Quarter, which is why I always assumed that's why it was called NQ, but you've got one in Liverpool, so I'm not sure if it started there and it's just spread with the same name, I don't know.
Yeah, it must have. But it was fun.
Yeah, it was like a retro arcade, but they sell beer. And so, yeah, I mean, I've not been to anything like that before. It was really good. We played... The first thing we did is play the Simpsons game.
As soon as I walked in there, like, so much nostalgia from, like, family holidays. We just go to, like, the seaside, and our big thing was we'd just go to the arcade, like, every day.
And that's so funny, because I had the same story. I was like, yeah, I remember going on this holiday, and, like, we could have been doing all these activities and stuff, but I was playing House of the Dead in the, like, in the lobby of the hotel thing.
Yeah. My favourite... arcade game though that they didn't have, unfortunately, is I don't even know what it's called. It's like you put the two pences. I don't know why I said that.
The two pences.
Two pence piece. And it the
oh,
rack
you mean
is like
the,
moving.
The like the sliding tray things.
Yeah, and
yeah.
It like pushes all the money out.
Yeah.
So all you do is win back like 40p.
Yeah.
But it's just so exciting as a kid, and you put like little cheap toys in there.
Yeah, the
like,
worst gifts. Yeah, little key rings and stuff.
No, you know what? Actually, I've got a key ring from one of them on my keys. It's a Jurassic Park one. It's really cool.
Yeah, that sounds great. I've never seen any kind of branded one in there. It's normally like... Oh, this is good podcasting. You're going to show me it.
Yeah. Oh, you can't see this, guys, but...
Trust me, guys. It's cool. Why is it blue? Jurassic Park logo isn't blue.
Maybe that's how they got around with
copyright. Right, yeah. Nice. No, it's...
No, it's real.
Yeah. All right. Hope you enjoyed that part, guys.
We'll put a picture on the Patreon. If you want to see this Jurassic Park keyring, you have to give us money.
Or, you know, bump into Sophie one day. And so, firstly, let's just say that because we went out in Liverpool, we're recording from Sophie's place, which is what she would refer to it as. I like to call it Sid's flat, because it's Sid's flat. But Sophie just dwells in this place.
Right, I don't... I live here, but it's not my place.
Yeah. It's like how there's a troll under a bridge, but the bridge isn't that troll's bridge.
I think it is.
No, I don't think so. Okay. Just because he gives you a riddle to let you across, it doesn't make...
When me and Sid are arguing, he refers to this as his flat.
That's totally the kind of shit I would pull.
Yeah.
Like
when the dog's being naughty and he's like, your dog has done this.
That's hilarious. Yeah. That's a great move.
My parents do that all the time. They're like, do you see what your son has done?
I'm going to use this tactic. I can't believe I've never thought of that. Yeah. So we're recording from Sophie's place. What that involves is that the cat and dog that we've talked about, Elvis and Loki, are here, so any animal noises in the podcast can be attributed to animals. So that's what that is, just so you know.
Yeah.
After we left the arcade bar, because one of the things about this place is that they only sold like expensive beers. It was
wasn't too expensive.
No,
but...
it was the regular prices they would be anywhere else, but they were the only options. That was the problem. So it's like, yeah, I'm willing to spend £5 on a can of IPA in a fancy place, or like if we're in some hipster bar or something, because I drink douchebag drinks.
Yeah.
But the only option was these £5 stubby cans of beer. So, you know, it's quite expensive. But because also it's underground and full of old arcade machines.
And it's really small.
And it's a tiny place. It was so hot in there. And then we went on.
Yeah,
so
you got like really thirsty. You just constantly wanted another drink.
Yeah, you had to keep buying these expensive beers. And you were drinking hooch, which is...
Oh, I like that. It's refreshing.
Yeah, it's lemonade. It's alcoholic lemonade. That's what that is. And we went on one of those dance machines.
Oh, I forgot all about that. It was great.
That was...
it wasn't actually, looking back. It was horrible.
You were terrible at it.
I beat you on Cotton Eye Joe.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
But to be fair, I had just had a practice run.
Yeah, you'd already played it once. No, but you did beat me. But then did you see me on 5, 6, 7, 8 by steps? I killed that.
Did you kill it?
Yeah, I was great at that. It's what I was saying, though, last night is that on those dance machines, if you can't hear the music, it's virtually impossible because...
You don't know what beat you're dancing.
Yeah, so it's all well and good looking on the screen.
You can see
the
moves coming up, but it doesn't like correspond to
anything. Yeah, it doesn't tell you... You don't know how long 3 millimetres of the screen is.
Yeah.
So there's no indication of when you're supposed to be dancing. And
there was only like 3 songs that we'd ever heard of. Like,
yeah.
5, 6, 7, 8 by Steps, Cotton Eye Joe by what, Rednecks, is it?
Yeah, and then...
Another Steps one.
Stomp by Steps, yeah, and they were the only ones that...
I say it was great, I'd probably do it again, but it was a wake-up call for how unhealthy I am, really.
Yeah, I was sweating. That was a tough dance. What else did we play? We played House of the Dead, which is one of my favourites. In the arcade, I just love the shooting games.
I love them. I also love the pinball machines. They had an Iron Man one, which was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Like, it had a lot of, like, moving aspects and lights, which I like.
Yes, okay.
Well, that was, what's it like when you get a baby letter toy that's, like, stimulating?
Oh, no, I was going to say, like, what's wrong with you? It was shiny!
But we played some other stuff too, didn't we?
Yeah, I played Mortal Kombat. They also had all old games consoles, and they were free to play.
Yeah,
that
was pretty cool.
And so, we went on Tekken on the PS1, but then they... Which I know is not, like, nobody's considering that a retro console, hopefully, but...
definitely they are.
Well, I mean, some people...
They had
a
SNES as well.
They
all had, like, various games on, didn't they?
Know if the PlayStation did, but that had one of those games that's, like, a 40-game cartridge or whatever. Yeah. They'd actually...
Cartridges, kids, that's what we used to have.
I don't know if...
And you had a blow on it to make it work. Remember that?
Yeah, I remember it, but you should... If you're going to say that, you need to explain in
Elaborate.
Detail. Because you can't just say, blow on it to make it work, kids.
Okay, so it was like a cartridge that... I don't even know if they understand what I mean by cartridge.
I know, I'm trying to think what an equivalent... I was going to say it's a little bit like a SCART lead, but nobody has SCART leads.
Shit! Yeah, and it'd get dusty, so sometimes you plug it in and it wouldn't recognise that there was anything in there, so you had to take it out and, like, blow on the inside, I guess, to get, like, the dust out or something.
Yeah, I don't know the...
It worked, though.
Yeah, I don't know the science, but it's kind of like when you take the back off your TV remote and roll the batteries around and then you get another few days out of them.
Yeah.
Like, nobody knows why, that's just how it is.
Yeah.
It's just one of those dad tricks that's just... it's a fact.
We were just talking about... Right as we were setting up to record this, suddenly the... Everything cuts out, like all the electric in the flat, and I heard Sid from the bedroom shout "fuck," and I was like, "bit of an overreaction," because he seemed really panicked by it. And then
"fuck shit,"
and then he said, "my telly's gone on fire."
Well, no, he didn't. See, I was confused because I've never been in your bedroom, and I didn't know you had a TV in there. He didn't say "my telly's on fire." He said "the telly's on fire," but we were sat watching the telly, and I thought, "how does he know that?" And it's not. I'm looking at it. It's fine.
I ran in there just I don't know why. Even as I was running in, I was thinking, what am I going to do?
Yeah, it's not
I just wanted to see it, really.
It's not like you had anything with you. You didn't take any, like, I know you wouldn't put water on an electronics fire.
Or a fire blanket or something.
Well, yeah, you didn't go in there with any preparation. You would have just gone in there and then also been in the room.
But
the telly's on fire, and now I'm here.
It was like smoking to fuck, but
smoking to fuck.
But it smelled really bad too. But Sid said, "oh, it's a really old telly. Like, I wonder if it's because the Xbox I plugged in is too powerful for it." And I was like, "that is just like something parents say to stop you from doing things. Like, that's not real." Games console is too powerful for the TV. That's what my mum and dad used to say when we wanted to play games in the living room.
I hate when we don't get a chance to prepare for a topic like this, but what are other things that your parents said, like just to, like, bullshit excuses to make you stop doing stuff? Like, you know, people who tell their kids that the ice cream van playing the music means that you've run out of ice cream.
Yeah. Or if you swallow apple seeds, a tree will grow inside you.
Oh, yeah.
Although, here's another one that was mostly kids in school, it wasn't parents. If you swallow, like, chewing gum, it'll wrap around your heart.
I've never heard that one.
Yeah, that gave me horrible mental images.
I just knew that you weren't supposed to swallow it, and I remember, like, it was the only person who would ever let me have bubble gum as a kid is my granddad, because my grandma hates it, and when my granddad was looking after me, he'd always let me have, like, a 5p bubbly from the corner shop. But then one time, like, I accidentally swallowed it. Like, I don't even know how that happened, but I was just like, uh-oh. Like,
you don't know what's going to happen.
Do
though.
I die now? What? And I went into my granddad and I was like, I swallowed that bubblegum. And he was just like, it's all right. Like, because at the end of the day, really, nothing is going
to
happen.
No, or what was the other one? It takes 7 years to pass through your system. How would that be inside?
Yeah.
I think all it is like you can't digest it.
Yeah, you can't digest
it.
Yeah. All right, sweet corn, but still eat that. You know, it takes 7 years. I definitely heard that one takes 7 years for chewing gum to pass through your system. Like, it's a drug that they could test you for. Yeah, yeah. If you've done chewing gum in the last 7 years. So after the arcade bar, because we left because it was sweaty.
And I was getting tired after all the dancing.
Yes. We went. Where did we go after that? We went to.
I have no idea. We'd been to the Swan for one as well.
Oh yeah! Oh, I forgot. Yeah,
the legendary Swan.
We went in the Swan first.
When I came in, I just like raised my arms as if I was some kind of savior and said, "I'm back," really loud.
You did do that
because I haven't been for too long.
And you're telling it, and nobody knows because nobody else was there. But actually, like, no one looked up, no one turned around. It was just me watching Sophie do that. That was the entire situation.
Yeah, no one really reacted. But when I got to the bar, some of the old men asked how I was doing because, you know, I used to see them, like, numerous times a week when I'd go drinking on my own.
That was always my understanding of coming, like, when I'd come to Liverpool to see you and we'd go day drinking, there'd be, like, three different times during the day that we'd go to the Swan. Like, right, well, we're going here, we'll see you later.
Yeah, we'll see you in a couple of hours.
So, I can't think where we went after the arcade bar, though.
Did we just go... Oh, we went to BrewDog.
Oh, we went to the shop and then we went to BrewDog, which I love, obviously, because I always drink BrewDog beer. We sat outside because, I don't know, because we were both hungover. Yeah, well, because we were both hungover, we wanted to not feel hungover anymore, but drinking just wasn't It just wasn't hitting the spot.
No, it's still not, honestly. I'm drinking now. And it's...
I know, I'm still trying to force myself into being drunk, and it was very difficult. So we sat outside for a while, and then we saw that they were closing in 10 minutes. So we went in and ordered a drink. Like, oh, we'll go and sit inside now. They'll have called last orders already, so we just went in and ordered a drink. And actually, one thing I've got to say about that place is, like we talked about in the last episode, that the difference between...
Oh, yeah. Kicking out time.
The kicking out, the behaviour of the staff. Brewdog was actually very friendly. I say Brewdog like it's a guy. Mr. Brewdog was very friendly.
The bartender was great.
Yeah, the lad behind the bar was nice. Also was 40 years old.
I was going to say, you just called him a lad.
Yeah, well, because he looked about my age.
Yeah, that's what he said was the key, the drinking.
Yeah, yeah. He said, if you drink good beer, you'll always look young. I mean, I'm inclined to believe the guy, because I thought he was 20 years younger than he was.
I know two people are a lot younger than we are, so...
Well, I do.
Fuck you. So, there's a new kid in my work, and he asked me last week. I think he's 20. I can really feel it now, when someone's, just become an adult, and I'm talking to them. I'm like, ah, my sweet summer child. But
What?
I think that's a Game of Thrones reference, but I don't watch Game of Thrones, so I don't know.
Good reference.
Anyway, he asked how old I was, and I was like, how old do you think I am? And he said, oh, I don't know, I'd guess 23, 24. And I just said, yes. One of those.
Yes, you are saying a number. I'm going to get another drink. Another. It's like I'm doing a lucky dip, reaching into my bag for a weird drink. Oh, I'm going to have this.
What is it?
Well, it's a Malibu pineapple.
That sounds terrible. I hate everything about that.
Made with Caribbean rum, coconut, and pineapple flavours.
The only good thing about that is rum.
And I know what you're thinking, guys. You're going to drink that after you just drank a latte? And the answer is yes. I'm going to vomit today. So...
You ever vomited in my toilet?
No, I've not.
Oh, well, there you go.
There we go. Let's try it.
Wait, I'm going to get a beer as well.
Okay.
That's Elvis.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can hear that, guys. Elvis! He usually stops when you shout.
Elvis is very old and...
crazy.
Yeah, losing her mind a little bit, so it's sad.
It is sad. Oh, I think all she wants is attention, but she's took it upon herself to move her entire life into the kitchen and won't leave the kitchen, so it's difficult.
What can you do?
It's difficult to give her that attention, because I don't want her to stand in my kitchen all day stroking her. Oh yeah, and she's called Elvis. Because they thought she was a boy. Not because she's, trans, but she might be. I've never asked.
Elvis. So after Brewdog, after we got kicked out of there at closing time...
Very politely.
Yes, very politely. Yes, very politely. Rude. Very politely escorted out of the premises. We went to Beer Engine. Did we go straight to Beer Engine after that, mm-hmm. I think? Which is this amazing place that... is open to 6 a.m. and serves food
every
till 3 a.m. And it's just so good. And I was so tired.
you were falling asleep.
Yeah, I do this thing. And as Aisha was explaining when she was on the podcast, I get sleepy just very suddenly. And so, I mean, it was 2:30 in the morning, but I was falling asleep. And for some reason, the thing I do, and every morning after I've done it, I wake up and I think, why do I do that? But I can't stop myself in the moment. If people say oh, you've fallen asleep, I'd deny it. Yeah. I'd deny it at all costs. It's no. I was, and then just whatever random excuse, I do it all the time. No, someone just took a photo there and the flash made me blink and it hurt my eyes. So I kept my eye, whatever crap I can come up with, because I will never admit that I'm tired for some reason.
Yeah, that's babies do that. Fuck or it. When people ask if you're drunk and for some reason you want to deny it, you're like, no, I'm fine.
Yeah.
I act like this all the time.
I always fall over.
That's just reminded me of a story that my mum tells of when one of my brothers, Mark, was in primary school. I think it was reception, so he was 5 years old. And he fallen asleep in class and fell off his chair. And obviously they went mad at him because he was a kid. But I think when the teacher said, have you just fell asleep? He said, no, no, I was just resting my eyes. Which is, why would a 5-year-old need to rest their eyes? is obviously something you've heard, like, on TV and, like, nods. Beer Engine usually plays good music, too.
I don't know if I've ever noticed the music.
It wasn't last night. It was just general
dance. Oh, yeah, no, I do remember now. Yeah, there was a lot of dance music that I didn't know.
Yeah, usually it's just, like, classic rock. It's, like, kind of universally friendly, really, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah, but I like that place. It's good. So in there, I drank whatever pale ale they've got on tap. But it was like a downgrade because drinking Punk IPA from any bar that serves it is like it's nice, but BrewDog's is obviously fresher and, you know, it's just better. It's
like when you go to Ireland and drink a Guinness, it's nicer.
Right. It's like it's a different colour and everything. So you know that what they sell to other people to sell is not the same
slightly
thing.
Slightly not as good.
Yeah. And to be fair, it's usually about £2.50 cheaper. So, you know, I mean, Weatherspoon sells it for £3.50 and BrewDog themselves sell it for £5.50. So wow. There you go.
It's a nice bar, BrewDog, though.
It is nice. Yeah, the food's really good in there. So because I'd been drinking that, then even though I drank something that any other night I'd have been absolutely fine with it, it just tastes like shit after drinking really nice punk.
Yeah.
So that's when the night kind of started to fall for me. I was just like, I don't really want this pint. It's hard to get through. And then I was falling asleep, and
that was the difficult thing about going out on a Sunday. Like, everywhere closes slightly earlier,
except Beer Engine. but then you and Aisha did Jaeger bombs. Now, I don't like Jaeger, but that's good for waking you up because it's got Red Bull, but I don't like Jaeger, so I did a shot of Fireball.
Oh, yeah, you look really unhappy when you did that.
Oh, like I was probably just falling asleep. I love Fireball.
Oh, it didn't look like you enjoyed it.
Oh, I did. I remember. It's warming.
Maybe that was your enjoyment face.
Yeah, you've never seen me enjoy anything before, that's why. Because yeah. I'm always with you.
Classic bants.
Got him. The Fireball didn't help me wake up in any way. So then we did Shot in the Dark. And we... I want to say it was called Dead Man's Fingers, something like that.
It was wrong.
I literally just went over to the bar, saw there was a bottle with a skull on it, and it looked cool, so I ordered those shots of that.
I enjoyed that.
It was just rum. It wasn't.
I've definitely had more offensive rums before. I would do it again.
There's a place, I think it's called Black Rabbit. Is it Black Rabbit in Liverpool, and they do something called the RIP shot. And it's like, I think it's two types of rum and a tequila, and they're all like 70-something%, and they're all in the same shot glass, and then they light it on fire, which burns the alcohol out. So, but it looks cool. Yeah. And I went to this place once, because I'd heard of it, this RIP shot, and I was like, well, I want to go and try that. So we went, and it was quite late, and I think it was a Sunday then as well. It was, because I worked the next day, it was horrible. The guy behind the bar was just so rude and miserable. And we went in, ordered those shots, and he didn't set them on fire.
Oh, no.
So not only was it a huge disappointment, but it was very, very strong alcohol. Yeah. Did that shot, we're out the night, whatever. And I had to be up, I had to leave for work at like 7 a.m. and travel from Liverpool to Manchester, which takes about 45 minutes. And I was still drunk when I got to Manchester. And I was just like, I don't know what I'm going to do. And I went into work and everyone was like, you're in such a good mood today.
And then, I'm still drunk.
Yeah, and like to the point where one of the managers in the office said, can you just come in drunk all the time? This is way better.
And so you told them you were drunk? Great.
Oh yeah, because it's not like I'd woken up on a Monday morning and had a load to drink and gone in work.
Oh, yeah.
I'd just gone out the night before. What was I supposed to do? It's like either I can come in work and I've still got some alcohol in my system, or I'll call in sick and you won't get any work out of me. But it was, you know,
yeah,
no true. Point.
I used to do that in my old job a lot. I'd try and hide it, but I think everyone must know.
Yeah,
I just be spending so much effort trying to be normal, but I'm never normal. So
yeah,
it's difficult.
And also when you're drunk.
You think is normal is not.
No, I was going to talk about you specifically. Something that you do all the time when you're drunk is ask if you're being normal. Or you'll go, is this weird?
Am I
being weird?
I used to do that in that job all the time as well. Like, every story I'd tell would be like, I don't know if this is weird, but... And then they'd be, like, rubbing their hands together like, wow, can't wait to hear this freakish tale.
Freakish tales of your life.
Yeah.
You should write a book.
Memoir. Yes. Oh, actually, my memoir's going to be called Why Did I Have That Last Pint?
That's great. That's a really good title. Yeah. You just blew it because someone's going to steal that now. One of our seven listeners. All right, I think maybe I'm getting there.
Yeah. what I was going to say about when you were talking about that shot that he set on fire, my brother Mark, who I just mentioned, he doesn't drink anymore, but when he did drink, I'd noticed that his lips always seemed really chapped, and I never knew why, and I was always just, like, it was something I had noticed but didn't really think too much about, and when I turned 18, I started going on nights out with him, and then I realised his lips were burnt because he used to set shots on fire in his mouth all the time.
What?
It was so good.
Every single thing you tell me about Mark makes him more insane.
Oh, I love him so much. He's the best.
Just that's... Why?
Because it looks cool.
I've never seen anyone even do that.
Yeah.
He's mental. That's crazy. One thing we should talk about, and you're going to have to talk about, is how we got home and got to bed, because I have no recollection of it.
Yeah, well, I wanted to stay out, really, even though there was not nowhere to go except Beer Engine. I was ready to carry on, but you were falling asleep, and I should have gone home at that point too. So I was like, there's no point in me staying here.
Staying and drinking while I sleep in a chair.
Yeah. So I called us a cab, and I don't know what it was, like 20 minutes probably, to my parents' house. Oh yeah, so recording this podcast from my house, but we stayed over in my parents' house because Sid had to get up from work really early, and he was like, I don't really want to have to get up and not be able to sit on the couch and have a cup of tea because Daniel's asleep on the couch.
Which is very fair.
Fair, yeah. Yeah. So we stayed in my parents' house, which is like just outside of town. When we got there, they were already asleep. So I just let us in, told Daniel where his room was, and then thought, oh, well, I can't go to sleep without wearing pyjamas. So I crept into my parents' room and got some of my mum's pyjamas. And obviously they woke up because there was someone in the room night.
Yeah, why did you do that? I would be terrified if you did that.
Yeah, actually I used to sleepwalk when I was a kid, and all I'd do was usually just get up and walk into my parents' room and just stand there. And my mum hated it.
Yeah, that's horrible.
Yeah, so then they were both awake, they both came downstairs and had just like to say hello to me and whatever.
And I'm devastated because I was asleep.
Yeah. I'm actually really disappointed. Yeah, I want you to hang out with my parents.
Yeah.
They love you.
I love them.
So yeah, I stayed up for a couple more hours.
And then you stayed in bed for a couple more hours.
Yeah. I woke up at 1.
Oh yeah, another half a day.
12-ish. And I had messages off Daniel from hours previously saying, are you awake yet?
Yeah, I messaged her at 9:30 a.m. saying, are you awake?
And because I didn't respond, he just stayed in the room.
Yeah, because the thing is that all the doors were closed upstairs. I've only been to your parents' house twice, and the last time was 5 years ago. And I didn't want to, like, walk in trying to find you, because I didn't know which door was what. I only half remembered where the toilet was, and I still opened the door thinking, please don't be Sophie's parents' bedroom.
Yeah. Well, all the doors would have been wrong because I slept on the couch anyway.
Why?
I was already on the couch, so I just...
Well, there you go.
I didn't want to go upstairs.
So, you didn't get to bed?
No, actually, yeah.
Which is, I think you're probably at about an 80% rate on podcast nights out of not getting into bed.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think every time you've stayed at mine, you've slept on the couch.
Yeah. Anyway, when I woke up, my dad was there to make us a sandwich, which was great.
And it was a good sandwich.
It was really good. It was, like, professional.
Yeah.
He only uses the best ingredients. Like, the roll was just...
Yeah,
it was
great.
Marks and Spencer.
Oh, well, there you go then. See, I can't afford to eat like that.
No.
One thing I really want to point out is when we discussed Sir Litbang, Barry Scott.
Yeah.
And we said, like, we explained it for the Americans. Any Americans listening, you also have Sir Litbang, but in your country it's called Easy Off Bam.
That's too many words for a product.
Also, bam, like BAM, like bang wasn't a thing in America.
Yeah.
Bam. Easy Off Bam.
But that's just making me think of Bam Bam of Flintstones.
Right, yeah.
I watched an episode of Flintstones recently, and as I was watching it, I was just like, The Simpsons is just the Flintstones. You know how you say all sitcoms are exactly the same?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Cartoons are the same.
Every sitcom is just episodes of Seinfeld rehashed.
Yeah, every cartoon is just episodes of the Flintstones, I think.
That's I didn't watch a lot of Flintstones.
I loved it.
Because even when we were kids, the Flintstones was an old cartoon.
Oh, it's
wasn't
really
it?
Old.
So,
yeah.
Like,
it still stands. So
no, totally. But it's just, you can tell from the animation that it's a little bit older and stuff. And as a little kid, anytime anything like that came on, I'd be like, oh, this one's not as good.
Oh, no,
I think it's because the colours are a little bit less bright.
I don't know. Maybe your telly was wrong. Maybe your telly was about to blow up.
Jesus. Anyway, I just want to play the advert for Easy Off Bam.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Easy Off Bam Power Cleaner has the power to remove stains like soap scum. Just spray and wipe wherever there's soap scum. Better than scrubbing bubbles. Bam, bam. Tiles, tubs, shower doors, sinks. Sinks. It even has the power to remove mind scale. Just spray it on and look at that shine. Easy off, bam! And you're done.
I hate that.
So the funniest thing.
That kind of commercial wouldn't fly in England.
No, but that's what's funny is we were saying how the Cillit Bang commercial is like,
it's English
it's,
funny.
It's but it's super Americanized.
Yeah,
and then
but
you
that's
watch,
like kind of the joke.
Yeah, but then you watch the American one and it's like, right, so you had to double down on yours. Cause like,
yeah.
Easy off, bam!
And why is it like doing that skipping like DJ thing?
Look at that shine.
I hate that.
The worst thing I've ever seen.
I thought
seen.
That was like someone had made that.
A remix?
Yeah, the remix. I wonder what the remix of that is like.
Holy shit, yeah. Yeah, I do. Please tell me that there is like a dubstep version that they play in clubs.
Yeah.
Like you wait for the drop and it's Easy Off Bam. Sorry, you were talking about the Flintstones. Did you have any further?
I did used to love the Flintstones and I have a really vivid memory of it when I was a kid at my dad's work, had like a party. You know, like they'd do these Christmas parties for the office and like everyone's kids would come and they'd have like child's entertainment and whatever. I used to love those, they were great, but this one year they had, what was it, like a game of musical statues? You know, where they play the music and you're like supposed to dance.
Right, yeah.
And then when he pause the music, you gotta like freeze. And if they see anyone move, they're out. Or if someone doesn't freeze fast enough, they're out.
I bet that's got like a crazy name in America.
Yeah,
probably. Bet that's not called musical statues.
Yeah. It's called Dancy Freeze Game Bam.
Dance, freeze, bam!
Yeah.
That's how that goes.
We were playing that, and the guy was a clown as well, who was, like, doing this game with us, which is creepy. It was between me and this one boy. We were, like, last on the thing. And now thinking back, he was probably just bored and wanted the game to end. But he started doing, because we were both so good, we were both killing it at musical statues.
Presumably not the dancing bit, though, is what I think after seeing you on that dance machine last
night. I've got moves.
You haven't got rhythm.
He started going, oh, can you just move a bit closer to the stage for us, please? I knew it was a trick, so I was like, no, I'm not going to move. This is like, he's trying to catch me out. The clown would be like,
right.
Oh, great, he's doing so good. He's both frozen. Can you just come here, like, take one step forwards because I can't really see you back there kind of thing. And he'd try and get us with that every time. And then he did it so much that I was like, he really wants me to move closer. So I did it. And then obviously I lost the game. And I was like, wow, this is...
That son of a bitch.
Is it? Yeah, right? I still hate them. But
it's a bit far.
For the second prize. Oh, no, it wasn't second prize. It was just like everyone who came got a toy from like Father Christmas. And I got a Flintstones video. And I loved it. I used to watch it all the time.
Do you ever think that, you know, if you have one interaction with someone ever and then you never see them again and you're like, yeah, I hate them. Do you think that's, like, it's justified because you spent that amount of time, so 90% of the time you've spent with that person ever, they were being a dick, so, like...
Yeah. Well, I don't know. Yeah, but then I think that about myself as well. Like, I wonder if anyone's met me briefly and thought I was a bitch.
Yes.
No, you haven't met me briefly.
No, I'm saying definitely that's happened.
Who?
Anyone who's ever met you briefly.
Oh, God.
Do you think my opinion's changed just because I've known you longer?
I think I've got the demeanour where I'm quiet, so I seem like I think I'm too cool, but really I'm just don't know what to say.
And also you think you're too cool.
Oh, I am, yeah. Absolutely.
It feels so rough. Like, I want to be drunk. I just want to skip all of this now and be drunk.
I'm feeling great.
when we would, because we just went to a restaurant to have a drink because Sophie specifically needed a Bloody Mary. And so I had an espresso martini, and then we both ordered that, and then the waitress came over and said, sorry, we haven't got any vodka, so what do you both want instead? Meaning, like, what white spirit do you want? And she said, do you want gin? And Sophie doesn't like gin. She's like, well, have you got anything else? And she was like, in terms of white spirits, no, not really. And I was like, yeah, I'm going to do her job for her here. So I just picked up the menu, looked at all the cocktails they did, and I was like, well, you have rum or tequila, so... So you had a tequila Bloody Mary.
Yeah, it was
and
delicious.
And I had a gin espresso martini. But I was saying to Sophie, like, it's fine because it's 2:45 in the afternoon and we're having a drink, but all of these people don't know that this is our breakfast and, yeah. And that we're doing this because we need to be drunk for this podcast. So,
yeah, we were just having brunch for all they knew.
Yeah, exactly. But, and I was thinking, like, it's a Monday afternoon, and I was saying, well, it's just liquid lunch for work, isn't it? But I've had this conversation quite a lot with different people. Everyone has different opinions on it. What's your opinion of drinking at lunch when you're in work? So, like, obviously, your job now, you work late hours and it's different, but when you worked in an office...
Plus, I work in a kitchen, so there's an element of danger if you're drunk, really.
Well, yeah, of course, there's that's a different environment. But you've worked in an office for a long time. Well, wasn't it? Was a...
7 years.
Laboratory.
Yeah. Basically an office.
What's your opinion on that? I mean, I know that you like to drink, so...
I say this, actually, interesting, because at the time, I worked in the office, and or lab, but you freaked me out by saying laboratory.
Well, because I was thinking of Dexter's lab.
Oh, yeah, that was me. based on my life.
Who was Dee Dee?
Mark.
Oh, yeah, Mark worked at the same place as her. It's not just...
Oh, yeah, I didn't even realise that was a joke. Anyway, when I worked in this office and lab, we did used to, now and again, go out for, like, a lunch around the corner to this pub. It was just, like, you know, one of those pubs that serve food and family-friendly and whatever.
Mm.
Now and again, they'd, like, either they'd treat us or we'd all decide, like, oh, can we have, like, a little bit longer for lunch and we're going to go around the corner. We'd, like, pre-order to make it quicker and all that. And I'd always... think, like, someone's gonna have a pint, please can we just have a pint? And someone would always mention it, like, oh, is anyone gonna have a drink? And then as soon as anyone says, oh no, I'm not, everyone was like, yeah, we shouldn't. And every time I was like, you're all pussies.
That's hateful.
I hated it. It was like taunting me. Why would you go to a pub and not have a drink? So I'm all for it, really, day drinking in work. A businessman's lunch.
Well,
but I've never actually done it, I don't think.
My team has a payday lunch thing that we do. If payday ever falls on a Friday, we'll go for a pub lunch and we'll have 2 pints is what you can fit in that amount of time, right? So we'll have 2 pints. Some of us will have 2 pints, me. They'll have 1 pint. But no, I mean, you can have a couple of pints and we'll go back to the office and then you have a brew and you're fine, you know?
Yeah.
And that's just something that we do in the Stoke office. But then I've had people comment on it when, like, I get, like, a bottle of beer with my burrito and bar burrito at lunch. And it's like, it's a bottle of beer.
Yeah, it's like half a portion, a bottle.
Yeah, so...
Or a third, even.
So, I don't get what the big deal is.
It reminds me of that whole thing about when people go on holiday. And they get to the airport in the morning and they think, oh, it's fine to have a beer now because I'm in the airport, I'm going on a holiday.
Yeah.
And they make a big joke about it, but if they ever did that, like, outside of the airport, I think they'd be, like, terrified of being judged. Whereas I'm like, well, you can drink any time of day you want. You're an adult.
Yeah. Also, time is...
A concept.
Just a man-made... Like,
oh, the sun is too high in the sky.
Yeah.
For me to drink.
You don't know my life. Yeah. Maybe I just... finished work. I might work nights. You don't know.
Yeah,
fuck you.
Totally.
You know what I mean? Like, I mean, I don't. But...
Yeah, well, people who do work might deserve to be able to go for a pint at.
Exactly.
In the morning.
But there's not enough people to justify the pubs all being open and stuff.
There's some pubs, I know.
Yeah, I know. I mean, you could go without spoons.
Yeah.
But how many drinks do you think is the cut-off? What's feasibly...
Probably 3.
3 pints.
Of a lunchtime, yes.
And you could go back, and I don't just mean like what's acceptable to drink during the day or whatever. I mean to go back to work and carry on working.
It depends how difficult your job is.
Well, what would be your cutoff? Not in the job you do now, because like you say, you've got to prepare
to have 3 and go back and do a shoddy job.
Right, but it would affect your working...
Only a little.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm saying...
Two is probably the sensible limit.
Yeah, because my question really is, what is the amount where if your boss pulled you up on it, you could still say, well, it's not changed anything, it hasn't hindered me in any way?
Yeah, I think two.
You think two? Okay, good.
But it's all personal, isn't it? Like, some people could have two and, like, really be really tipsy.
Well, yeah, I mean, that certainly is this. We do have the diversity of that on our team, where...
If I haven't ate anything, two is my absolute limit. Where, like, as soon as I have, like, the first sip of my third beer, there's no return.
I'm exactly the same, but to be honest, when I haven't eaten, it's probably one. And there's no pulling it back. Like, it's just...
You can eat all you want after that, but you're still completely smashed.
it's never going to save you. Yeah. And that's something that really, really affects me, like, if I drink when I've not eaten, which it's funny because I wanted to talk about this anyway, but it's natural segue, and I've ruined it by saying there's a natural segue. I do another podcast, a Bowling for Soup fan-oriented podcast, me and Jarrett from BFS, and it's all kind of contributed to by the fan page and stuff. And we recorded one while I was in Texas at his house, but he took his son and his son's friend wakeboarding first. And there was a bar, restaurant type thing just next to the place with big windows and everything, so you can watch everyone do it, but you sat in the bar. And we went in there, Jarrett did some work, and I got a beer, because what else am I going
to
do?
Well, what are you going to do in a bar when you're in another country and have no work to do?
Exactly, I was on holiday. But Aisha was really jet-lagged. It was like the first day we were there. It was the first day. We'd arrived the night before, and the second we landed, Jarrett texted me and said, "This is the bar I need." Like, see you soon.
Amazing.
And I was like, man, I don't know. Like, you know, we'd just done this, like, 10, 11-hour journey. We were tired, you know, but we were hungry as well.
That's what we did when we went to Texas, though.
Well, yeah.
We stopped off at, a gas station to buy beer. And
that's
then
true.
Just went to the, what was it?
The bus, the old Bowling Soup's rehearsal space.
Yeah.
But
it was, like, 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
Anyway.
But it wasn't that late when me and Aisha got there, but I just said to Jarrett, like, do they do food? And he was like, yeah, the food here is great. So I was like, right, well, there you go then. So we went back to the hotel, went to the hotel, checked in, dropped our stuff off, went to the bar, drank. And then, like, at the end of the night, it was like, right, see you later. And Jarrett's like, and we were recording the podcast the next day, and Jarrett's like, I'm, you know, taking the boys wakeboarding in the morning, so just text me in the morning and we'll figure it out. So I just went to that with him because it was cool to watch.
Yeah.
But I didn't eat because Aisha was jet lagged, so didn't want to come straight away because I was leaving early in the morning to go to this wakeboarding thing before we did the podcast, but she was going to join us afterwards. So I'm thinking, right, well, I won't have lunch yet. I'll wait till Aisha gets here. But then she slept for hours, which, you know, we were severely jet lagged, so it was, you know, reasonable, but I can't sleep during the day, even if my body is like, you must do this. I envy people who can sleep during the day. We've just done this horrible journey, so it was reasonable that she would sleep. But I'm like, right, no. Because she might text any minute and say she's on the way, and I don't know if I've had lunch, and then she's got to eat on her own. That's weird. So I didn't eat. But then it was hours and hours, and I was just hammered. Like, I could barely speak.
Was she mad?
At this point, she's still asleep. We've got to Jarrett's house. He's showing me round. And I'm just like... He's telling me about, like, cool things in his house and, like, yeah, this is from the Grammys and blah, blah, blah. And I'm just like, wow, I don't give a fuck about, I can't even listen.
Was he drunk?
No, he was looking after his kid. He hadn't even had a drink. Oh. I was shit-faced. And he's like, because I said, can I just use your toilet? And he's like, oh, yeah, just, yeah, in there, if you look above the, and I'm just like, I'm going to piss my pants if he doesn't show up. And I felt so bad as well. Like
you're so rude.
Yeah, you know, he's showing me all of this cool shit, and I'm like a massive Bowling for Soup fan, and he's showing me all this cool memorabilia and stuff, and I'm just like, my God, I can barely see straight. And then we had to start the podcast.
God.
So if you go and listen, I think it's episode 10. It's called the BFS Fan Page Rampage. And
it's a great name.
It's actually originated from a typo when Jarrett was texting me about it.
Amazing.
And I was just like, dude, we've got to call it that.
Yeah.
And
if you're a fan of Bowling for Soup, their fan page on Facebook is like great.
Yeah, go yeah, the Bowling for Soup fan page on Facebook.
It's like a really good like community.
Mm-hmm. But if even if you're not a fan of Bowling for Soup, go listen to episode 10 of that podcast just to hear me. I hated listening back to it because I was so drunk. And all I could think was, am I this annoying all the time when I'm drunk? Everyone must hate me.
They do.
Yes, I thought that as much. I mean, we held it together fine. There's a bit, like, probably 5 minutes in where Jared just bursts out laughing and goes, are we really doing this? Because I could barely speak and I'm trying to read these notes and I'm like, I just couldn't get through it. But we pulled it together. And at that point, when he says, are we really doing this? He goes, because, like, live band karaoke's on at the bar and, like, we could just go to Lava Cantina now and do that. And I'm like, no, let's just hurry through this and we'll then we'll go to the bar and carry on drinking.
Wow.
But it was kind of the same as our podcast now, whereby towards the end of it, he was like, I'm getting that. I'm pretty sure I'm now. Man, that was a rough day.
I forgot why we even started to talk about that.
Oh, I just wanted to talk about that one because it just came out. We recorded it in June, but it just came out because, like, we just never got, like, Jarrett never got around to release. Yeah, because it needed, we rarely edit that pod. Well, I say we, Jarrett does all the work. He rarely edits that podcast because we don't need to. We just kind of, we get through it. Because it's much more organized than this podcast because I have all the notes prepared and it's more like an interview type format than this. So it doesn't really need editing, but that needed editing a lot. Like, especially because, like, I've never done this during the podcast before, but I was just like, you know, I need to pee, I need to get up and get beer, and man, they've got a mini fridge in his studio. Obviously, that's his actual recording studio, so it's obviously kitted out better than my laptop with a microphone attached to it, you know, but just having a mini fridge is such a good idea, and it kind of...
Stop rubbing this in my face. I haven't provided a mini fridge for this podcast.
I haven't got a mini fridge either.
Yeah, but you have a cooler.
Yeah, but it harps back to our original first episode. Because the thing about the mini fridge...
Yes, I was going to say that.
But no, but this is... This is an actual... Like you would see in a hotel or something.
Amazing.
It's not just like the one that Aisharaz that's like...
The one from Argos.
The Argos one, yeah. Let's not cover old ground.
You just did that thing that you do when you're drunk where you always say, yeah, but no, but...
100%. And that's one of the things that I can notice myself at the time. I'm like, wow, I'm annoying.
And that's not annoying at all.
Sometimes, because I know that, like, it annoys me, that's for sure. But Aisha will say something and it's kind of like I'm saying... Yes, I know what you're saying, but no, I think this. But I'll go, yeah, no. and I'm like, I'm that guy off the Vicar of Dibley. No, yes.
I've never seen it.
I want to quit the podcast.
It's friendship, is it?
Friendship, that seems a bit far.
What, this isn't a friendship? Is that what you meant?
Yeah, I wouldn't call it that. I mean, I know you. I'm going to get a drink. This is the last of the Lucky Dip. Sorry about all this noise, guys.
Rustling.
The rustling.
I like it. It's exciting.
What, the rustling?
Yeah, it adds an element to the podcast that even though you can't see this, you know what's happening. Sound effects.
It's an audio board of background noise that shouldn't be in the podcast.
Right.
We
can't hear that rain outside.
This last can is Archer's Schnapps, perfectly mixed with lemonade, how it described it on the can.
That one sounds nice.
Yeah, Schnapps is fantastic.
Because I was thinking about when you had the pineapple one, a big thing that people like to do.
Just 1 second.
Nice.
Probably wouldn't have even heard that. That's how pathetic all of the cans I drink out of.
Yeah.
How do I drink out of quiet cans? What's that about?
You're not a badass like me.
Yeah, sorry. Carry on.
A thing that people love to do, which I hate, and it always seems to come up with pineapple because I don't like pineapple. Like any kind of, what is it, like tropical drinks. I can just take the pineapple and I don't like it. And people are always they do that thing where you say you don't like something and they insist on you trying it.
Oh, yeah.
That's so bad.
Do you know, people do that with alcohol more than anything else. And you know, the most common one for me, because I don't like Jaeger, is Jaeger bombs. Like, it's like, oh, you pussy, just have one.
I always forget that you don't like it.
Yeah, but I'm like, I don't like the flavour of that. Well, it's not that I can't handle it.
Yeah, I'm trying to have a good time.
Give me a shot of anything else. I don't like Jaeger.
Yeah, it's always pineapple with me because I guess that's really popular flavour. I don't know, but and they always say, you can't even taste the pineapple, and you taste it, and that's the entire flavour.
That's always the way if there's something in it you don't like, that you taste that so strong. Because I'm
that like coffee.
Right, yeah. I'm like that with tomatoes. If there's tomato in something, it's only really small pieces.
What
about
like pizza and like tomato sauce?
I'm fine with any kind of pasta tomato sauce. You know, if it's meatball marinara, spaghetti bolognese. Fine with pizza. Don't like ketchup. Don't like tomatoes. Don't like tomato juice. Don't like Bloody Marys. No matter how many times you're the one complaining about it, but you did that today.
I didn't get you to try it.
You told me I should have one.
Did I?
Yeah.
Oh.
You should get one of these. And I was like, I already said on the way here, I don't like
Did
Bloody
I
Marys.
Say that?
Yeah.
Are you sure I wasn't talking about orange juice?
I know what you said.
Okay. Whatever. But yeah, there's a couple of people who always try and do it to me for some reason. My friend Annabelle and my dad always do this. Yeah, it's just, I don't know, I just don't under, like, my taste buds are different than yours. Like, why do you think I will like the same thing?
And also, one thing about you is that you know what you like and don't like more than anyone I've ever met. Like, you're just like, no, not having.
Yeah, because like you say with drinking, why would you want to have a bad time when you're trying to have a good time?
Yeah, exactly.
And why would I want to eat food that makes me upset?
Makes you upset? That's...
I love food. Like, why are you giving me bad things?
Yeah, I totally agree on that one. I'm mad thinking about it. And I can't even think of an example of the time it's happened to me, but I know it has, so I'm angry.
There was one time when we met Colin. Colin, hi. I don't think she listens to this. Every time we mention someone, we're just like, I don't think they're listening.
Yeah. Why are none of our friends listening to our podcast?
Yeah, little bastards.
And it's not like strangers are, so who the hell is? No one.
They have enough of us in real life, I think that's what it is. Can't handle any more of our shit. Yeah, we went to Starbucks once, and I didn't get nothing because I don't like coffee, but she was trying to pick herself up, I think, for the day, and whole day she was just like, wow, this is not doing anything for me. Like, we were walking around and she wanted to be nurses a coffee, like, she likes it cool.
Oh yeah, she has that, what did she call it, baby coffee
temp.
Oh, baby
kids,
temperature,
kids temp. It must be like
terrible. Grow up Colin.
What they say in Canada, because I agree, because every time I make someone a cup of tea or whatever, I'm like, wow, this is too hot to ingest. Why? What do you want?
There is a very frustrating element of making yourself a brew, and it's like, right, well, I'll have that ready in 5 minutes.
Yeah, and then if I take much longer, it's cold and horrible. But she was like, oh, this is not working. She was like, you know, this sounds really stupid, but I think they forgot to put coffee in my coffee. And I was like, come on. Starbucks forgot to put coffee in your coffee. And I was like, there's no way, I'm sorry. So anyway, eventually she convinced me to try it, and I was like, listen, this is going to be horrible, I'm going to hate it, but I'm going to do it for you because you're my friend. I tasted it. It was just milk.
There was no coffee.
They forgot to put the coffee in.
I mean, to be fair, that's just like one component of the drink, so if they just forgot an ingredient, it's laughable because it's Starbucks. No,
though.
But, well, it's not. I mean, obviously, it's a requirement.
Yeah, she has, other things, like vanilla or, like, syrup.
No, but I mean, like, if, for example, if it was a latte, something. That's mainly milk. So,
I see.
Like, most of the cup is hot milk. So yeah, they just forgot one ingredient. And because it's Starbucks, obviously, it's funny that it's the coffee. But I can see how that...
Yeah, everyone makes mistakes and whatever, but still.
But never again, Starbucks. That's your one. I feel terrible.
Yeah.
Well, this has been episode 8. Sorry, it was terrible. Or at least, I feel terrible, so I assume it was.
Hope you feel bad too, guys.
I hope your hangover is also terrible.
You did this.
Please like, subscribe, whatever options you have, wherever you listen to this. Check out our Patreon. It's patreon.com/ahyddpod. And follow us on all social media at ahyddpod.
Give us some feedback if you like it or hate it.
Oh yeah, leave us a review. We love reading reviews.
Message us if you think it's... You don't want to leave us a bad review. Just give us some personal feedback.
Yeah, tell it me privately. Someone said in an iTunes review that something I said is one of the most relatable things they've ever heard. And
wow,
I can't remember, but I was like, oh my God, this is it. We've made it. We're going to blow up. I'm relatable. I'm relatable content.
Yes.
So yeah, you know, it just makes me happy for a little second. You know, just it gives me a buzz for a moment. So, you know, leave us a review.
Give us a buzz without drinking.
Thanks for listening. Is that everything? Is that all the sign-off we did?
Yeah, I love you.
We did. Who? Me? Or the guys?
Listeners.
The guys, not me.
The guys.
The guys.
Hey, guys.
Bye-bye.
We're going to do that every time.
Well, we have to now.
Bye.
Bye. Goodbye forever.
Are they still drunk? Are they hungover? Sophie and Daniel, definitely not sober.
Thank you for listening to the Hangover You Don't Deserve podcast.